Oh my Latina.
Hola perras.
Hola perras. Hola puta pendejas.
Yeah, I'm a puta pendeja apparently.
You are.
From our last video.
No, you are.
Hi, Hi dragons.
What's up? It's Nikita and
Jenny69.
And today, not only are we gonna be YouTubers, but we're also gonna be Latinas.
So I'm gonna be teaching her today how to be a Latina. We're gonna start off with some glam and we're gonna be doing Latina things all day, so I'm so excited. It's not that hard to be a Latina. I feel like you're a quick learner.
I am trying. It's in my blood. Okay, mm-hmm. So some of you guys may or may not mother effing. Some of you guys may or may not know this, but I actually am half Mexican, also Vietnamese, but my mom is full-blown Mexican and I feel I'm just kind of in between, mm-hmm. You know? If you're a mixed kid,
I do get like a Latina vibe from you, for
my,
sure.
My personality, my attitude is very, like, that. I feel like Latina. Because mm-hmm. I feel like I'm like a little Asian girl, but with like an attitude.
And mostly like, I only get along with Latinas, so it's weird that like we get along.
That's what I'm saying.
We're low-key primas, like on
primas.
The low.
Primas! So in today's video, I have Jenny69, AKA the Baddie Bee, AKA the Latina, AKA the baddest perra I have ever met in my entire life. And honestly, I am so honored that she is here with me today because we have been friends for kind of a minute.
For a minute, honestly.
For a minute. Mm-hmm. And we kind of slowly but surely realized that our personality is like kind of on the same.
Right. We just never filmed.
I don't know why.
Like when I met you, I'm never like, oh, like let's take a picture. Let's film a video.
No.
Like I always like to build relationships. Mm-hmm. And then it's like, well, if it happens, it happens.
You know? Also too, we're like, well, I mean, at least for me, I don't really, as we know, like I'm just starting to become a YouTuber. Hi 2020 as the beauty
influencer
of the year 2019. I just feel as though now it is time. So we are learning in Espanol how to be a Latina. We're getting ready. We're drinking our café.
Mm-hmm. Our little café. This actually came out really good.
She's a barista. I just say, you know, the perra, the bad bitch lifestyle is not for everyone.
No, it really
isn't. Especially the weak. Mm-hmm. But we're gonna do it in Espanol, so it'll be entertaining.
Okay. Vamos a empezar, pues.
Vamos.
You need to watch Dora the Explorer, bitch.
How do you say moisturizer in Spanish?
Well, I say crema. I'm kind of more like the hood Mexican. Crem. Like my parents are from a rancho, so like we don't speak like proper Spanish, so uh-huh. It's kind of like hood with it Spanish. You know what I mean?
I'm gonna go in with my,
of course,
El Dragon Beauty because I have a little bit of la discoloraciones. Pero like mustache. I go from compadre to mommy.
I'm fucking dead, dude. Okay, rule number two for being a Latina. If you do have like Latina lingo, you're a Latina. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Wait, do you want some?
Yeah, I'm over here like, what should I use?
I have a new one, but I feel like it's very Latina sharing to like right. Share. On a real note, for real, and es inglés. Pero like, I use this to color correct my 5 o'clock shadow, mm-hmm. To color correct my darkness around the mouth. But before the foundation, because don't want it to pop through the foundation, because that's right. What happens to me. Like,
empezamos con el corrector de Dragon Beauty. Y es un color anaranjado.
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 Y este, no se asusten del color porque cuando se lo ponen, se lo tienen que poner antes de su, del base. El base viene siendo el foundation. No sé cómo se dice foundation en español, pero esto te ayuda como corregir los under eye bags.
Corregir,
ajá, los under eye bags.
Under eye bags.
Para que cuando termines de hacer tu maquillaje, los under eye bags no se ven.
No se ven.
You know what I mean?
Okay, so for me, I'm obviously being a little dramatic, but I truly.
Yeah, what aren't you? Like, bitch, I've never even seen you in a natural look, bitch.
But what I do is I kind of like soften it with like a little beauty blender vibe, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So what foundation do you use?
Well, recently I've been obsessed with the NARS Sheer Glow.
Okay.
It's really, really good. It's because I have dry skin.
You do?
I have super dry.
That's like crazy. Super I don't know dry. Why you, I just, I don't know why.
You would assume since I'm Latina, I have oily. Maybe I'm not a real Latina.
Are you excited to go to Santee Alley?
I'm so excited to go to Santee.
This bitch said, we're gonna go to Santee Alley on a Saturday with star pasties and act like, oh, you know, just shopping.
Don't act like you weren't down.
I honestly was. I was like, okay, if Nikita's down and I'm going with Nikita, okay, that's fine.
How are you more yellow than me and I'm the Asian one?
I don't know, I think it's my foundation. Oh my God. I feel like foundation is the hardest for me to like figure out because like really? My skin tone changes and you know when you have your spray tan, like it goes through its phases.
Oh, bitch.
So I always end up having to do like the most with like my body foundations because mm-hmm. my face is always dark.
Pase la base.
Okay. Pase la base.
I think I'm gonna add a little bit of like whatever color you have, just a little bit. So like we're like very skin.
So we're like, okay, 20. I love the NARS colors. Yeah, I feel like they'd be knowing the vibes.
I'm taking a break from spray tanning. I'm sure the world is like cheering in the background like, yes! Finally, let's get on our crazy spray tans! Yes, I know. I've had very not so great spray tans in the past. Sometimes they've gotten me in trouble.
They always look good.
I have a very high risk of like melanoma and skin cancer in my family.
No way. Who has
it? One of my very close, close family members. I guess I can say it. I don't know if I've ever like really talked about it. I guess because I just really don't like to talk about sad things, you know?
Yeah, that's kind of how I am too. We're just like,
I'm like that type of bitch that I'm like, one, I don't like people to really necessarily feel sorry for me. And second of all, it's right. like, mm-hmm. also too, it's like, you know, it's life, it's hard. And it's right. something very like tender and soft and painful. But my sister was diagnosed with stage 2 developing melanoma.
That's scary.
And she had like multiple scares with it, and it was just like it was shocking to my family because we had no idea that it kind of like ran in my family. We were the type of family where like my family and I, we would like would have competitions to see who could get the darkest in summer. Like we would just lay out and just like get freaking like dark like dark cafe, like, you know, 12 shots of espresso. It was a really scary time for like my whole family.
Did she have to like go through chemo and stuff?
She didn't. She had just a lot of just like different, like they just removed it. You know, like they just like literally just like scraped the whole thing out and just like.
How do they do that? They like just, underneath like,
they,
the skin?
Yeah, they like just cut the whole piece out and then just like sew it.
Oh, so it was like an area that was like, mm-hmm. that's so weird. I've never heard of that.
Yeah.
I've never heard
of that. It's one of those things where it's like a mole, right? And then it's like then the mole starts like.
Yeah, you know what? I think my cousin had that. Bitch. That's why right after, like, I went and I got all my moles removed. Because mm-hmm. when you're Latina, you just have a lot of moles.
I have one. I had a birthmark.
You
right
got
here.
It. You got it removed.
And I got it removed right after.
Shut the f- up! Mm-hmm. Oh my God.
Because I was really scared.
That's how you know we're primas. Like we're related because we both got our moles removed like yeah. around the same time.
But on a lighter note, why I'm not spray tanning is because recently I was with a boy.
Tell us that story.
Literally, it's like, if you spray tan or you tan, you know the smell of like spray tan. Yes. Like, you know for that whole week, your tan is gonna smell like weird. Or your skin, like no matter how much you wash, like if you have a spray tan, like you know you're gonna have like a little bit of like a
of
smell.
That scent.
And this guy I was with was basically like, you smell like spray tan. I'm like, and I literally said immediately, I was like, that's the smell of LA.
That was your comeback.
Yeah,
bitch.
I was like, that's the smell of LA, bitch. Hello. So I'm just gonna take a little break. Just a little bit. Jenny, as the bad perra that you are, what is like your kind of like, I hate to say New Year's resolution because I feel like it's so singular. Mm-hmm. But what are your kind of like New Year like goal? Like
I wanna learn how to put myself first because I feel like I'm so giving. And you know, other people would say like, oh, Jenny, you're like so selfish.
Not me, bitch, because I know how much you give.
I really
but behind
do.
The scenes, you know, giving
you
person
don't know
is
like my family when, or like that kind of stuff. Exactly. So I give a lot. I do. I really do give a lot. And I don't know, I just kind of feel like my happiness comes first. Mm-hmm. And I really want to work on just putting myself first, no matter if that means I'm going to lose everything. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. But that's a hard thing to like. As not
it's a
only,
hard thing to do
as
when you're
woman,
a mom,
especially.
Because when you become a mom, bitch, it ain't about you anymore. Like dead ass. Okay, let's do it. This is the Nikita routine.
No. If you've never tried the brightening pink bacon set from Morphe, this is like my holy grail, like set foundation. What are you?
My makeup
like,
artist
setting.
Uses it too.
Like it's so good. We're gonna make our own.
We're gonna make tortillas.
Tortillas. With this. Honestly, it kind of looks
Low
like a
key, it does, yeah.
Literally, I think I could survive off of just quesadillas my entire
same,
life.
Same. Like, because they're so easy to make.
Oh my God. I always have to, like, put, like, so much powder on my eyes do.
Really?
Yes.
You're oily like that?
Yeah, like in my brows too. Like my brows actually always like the most oily. So I'm gonna be using the Dragun Beauty face palette, you know. Back when I was tan.
I mean, bitch. When you tan,
I go off.
Yeah, this is so bomb for really sculpting the face.
It's just so neutral.
Mm-hmm. I feel like there's no bronzer like this. I wouldn't even consider this a bronzer. I'd call it like a sculpting powder.
This is just full on just sculpting.
But like if somebody doesn't know about makeup, like you would call it a bronzer.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I can't believe we're still working on our face.
I do this. I do. I sit here. Bitch, you act. Okay, what I do for my nose contour, I'll tap like one little like
a tiny little bit.
And they'll go under like just the tip right here to like lift it. And then for blush, I'm gonna use Baby Girl. Bitch, we're starting to look cute.
I know, the brows are on.
Okay, so we had to take a second pause to get the brows. How do you say it?
Cejas.
To get the cejas correcto. And we are now gonna start doing our eyeshadow. I typically don't go in with eyeshadow, if I'm being honest. Like, I just kind of like go like, mm-hmm. like really fast.
You do like a little like wash of brown or something.
Mm-hmm. But Jenny,
I mean, that's kind of what I do, but I just like layer different kinds of browns.
Yeah. Do you that's like how cut you get the crease it in the whole thing?
I don't really cut crease it. If I do, like it's more to get the color pigment payoff and then I just blend it in. Because you want it to look like you didn't try.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Okay. So what do you start off with first?
So I use a little bit of bronzer just to kind of like...
On like a fluffy...
On a really fluffy brush.
Like fluffy round. You know I met you while you were pregnant?
Yes, I remember.
You remember that? Mm-hmm. I met Jenny actually with my old face.
Yes, and you had like really short hair. It was the night after the Anastasia Beverly Hills Halloween party, remember?
Oh, yes.
That was the first time I saw you and I was like, who is that? She was like dressed as a little mermaid with her little, what is that called? A little anchor thing?
Yeah.
Walking around the party.
Tried it? Oh, bitch, I was getting
not an anchor, bitch. An anchor is
an anchor, yeah. And you don't really like, you don't really worry about like crease. You kind of just like blend. You like.
Yeah, I always just blend because I feel like you can build it up. You can eventually go in with that one. OMG, like on my everyday like makeup looks when I don't have time, like this is the palette that I go in. Like I literally use this to sculpt and then this in the crease. And it's literally a look.
Ooh, okay, Miss Yenny.
A little brown moment. So rule number four on how to be a Latina. We're gonna go ahead and start off with our wing liner. Do you know how to do like a proper wing liner?
I know how to do a wing liner, but I don't think I know how to do a Latina wing liner.
Okay, so you're gonna have to really drag that shit out. We're gonna make it super sharp. Okay. So I normally like to start off with the wing first.
Okay.
So I draw the line and then I draw the line on the other side and then kind of start in the middle. You could just follow me.
You don't even need to do like a little V like hack or anything. You're just like boom.
I just go in because you always want to go in with the length. Like I literally drag it out here and then I kind of go in here. I mean, you can follow my steps, but honestly, since you're a beginner, I don't know if you should follow the steps.
No, I'm gonna follow. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay.
I'm watching.
But you're literally making me so nervous. Okay, here we go.
Boom, period. Mm-hmm. You go up, you don't go out. You go
up. And it's kind of, it kind of sucks because sometimes I don't even know what my hand is doing. I just kind of like let
it just
it be.
Goes there.
Yeah.
The Latina-ness just knows.
Yeah, this is weird. But this is that like Latina. Traditional like Jenny 69.
That is like such a specific angle, okay. How pointy do you make yours? Like very pointy?
Mm-hmm.
Bitch, get your Latina game together. Bitch, we are getting together. My voice is back on Tecunty mode and it is about time to stop with the humbleness and get into full perrita. What does that even mean?
Perrita. Like perra. Like bad bitch.
Perrita mode with Miss Yenny 69 and put on our baddie bee lashes.
So for today's look, we're gonna be going in with Saucy. This is one of my favorite styles for sure because it's still like really fluffy, but at the same time, it's still kind of spaced out in between to kind of give you that smize.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, it's pretty simple. I mean, just glue them on like, girl. It ain't that hard. Yeah, look at the difference between lash and no lash.
Oh, bitch. Bitch, I just feel like such a bad bitch now. Like, oh my God. Okay, so we're pretty much almost done with this look. And Miss Jenny gave me this lipstick to try.
I've used it so much. It's honestly-
Clearly, empty. It might be a little bit of her fave, so we're gonna test it.
It's cute. I do like it, yeah. I do like it. We're both wearing Sweet Tea lip liner.
Okay, I can't show what lip I'm trying out, but just know I've been testing out certain things. So I'm gonna go over here and try something. Hold on, bitch. Wait a minute.
That looks so pretty. I love that lip combo. Uh-huh.
Okay.
I love it.
Yay!
Did you mix like a lot of things?
No, just like, I think you would. You I did like a little bit of that. Okay. This thing. Oh, I know what's missing. Because real Latinas don't let their makeup smudge, bitch. Is like, I've never seen a Latina with like smeared like liner really out and about. You know what I mean?
Never.
You it might be smoky, but it's never like f***ed up.
Don't ever f*** Latina with brown lip liner on, girl.
Wait, are we done with our makeup?
We really are.
But something's missing.
Mm-hmm.
We need just a little bit of like a highlight. I think we should be, you know, a little Latina and risque and use a little bit of silicone right here. This one's more of like a, it's just not so like, ugh, highlight, like gross, because I'm like really not a fan. It's just more of like a little
like whisper. A little sparkle.
But if you want to really go there, obviously you can like go, right. Go in.
I feel like now we're at our full
perra. Now we're at the full perra.
I feel like now we're done.
Now we need to put on this outfit, bitch.
We really do.
Okay, we need to go. We need to go.
Okay, so now that we have our makeup full Latina style, I'm here with Nikita Dragun. I haven't fully introduced her yet to YouTube, but
yeah, I don't think you have.
If you've seen her on my Instagram, y'all, like this is another reason I feel like I have to teach her culture, her Mexican roots, mm-hmm. and be a great Latina mama. Go ahead, Miss Jenny. Okay. What's her outfit?
So today we're gonna be serving a super Latina fantasy for sure. I'm gonna be wearing a white version of Nikita's outfit. So Nikita's gonna be serving like extra Jenny 69 mm-hmm. realness. She's gonna be wearing like a rosario, mm. super like gallo vibes for sure.
Man, gallo.
Get into these star pasties though, bitch.
This was the look that I saw on Jenny's page and I was like, oh my God, this is divine Latinaness to its full capacity and I wanna serve this fantasy. Like I felt so proud and like she just was the baddest bitch. I was like,
it's gonna be everything. Like honestly, they ain't ready for it.
I'm like here to put it on.
Bitch, bring out the wig.
Bitch, okay, we need to change. We're changing, bye. Bitch, I feel like there's two of us.
Yeah, I feel like I'm looking at myself in the mirror. Like literally double angel.
Double, like.
Latina. I am so shook right now.
We're literally at our fullest perra potential. Primas as fuck. Like, I feel like I'm looking at Jenny 69 right now.
I mean, even just hearing this.
Right?
Like, even just hearing this, I'm just like, bitch.
You're just so Latina right now.
This has truly been a eye-opening experience.
Honestly.
Very mira, mm-hmm. mira. Y todo full fantasy. Mm-hmm. Y todo full fucking Latina moment. Puta pendeja perra. To the fullest. And I'm getting my entire life. I don't know if I should ever do this again because I feel some type of way, you know what I mean?
You're gonna be so addicted. Like, it's honestly addicting being a Latina. Once you serve one Latina look, it's over. You're gonna be
just
doing so many.
Listen, this is too much for y'all to handle, too much for me to even handle. A special thank you to my girl, my puta pendeja perra, Jenny 69 herself, the queen Latina, for letting me be a full fantasy Latina
today. I had so much fun.
You like really awoke the Latina in me.
And I feel like there is nobody else that I'd rather do this than with you, bitch.
I hope you guys really enjoyed this. Let us know down below if Jenny and I should do more Latina moments or if I feel like we should make this like a thing. Like we should like go do
every
like
video that we do has to be Latina. So let us know in the comments down below. We're down to do whatever.
Don't forget to go check out Jenny, obviously on her channel, her Instagram, the baddest mother effing perra out there, Jenny 69. You already know, obviously her brand, go support because these lashes are everything and I'm not just saying it. I might be just saying it, but like I feel cute, bitch.
Right.
Like, you know what I mean? Like it's just undeniable. It's undeniable. I mean, obviously subscribe, but hello, we all know I'm an amazing YouTuber. I'm gonna start uploading crazy. And don't forget,
breathe fire my dragons.